Want to get away? Now you can. With fares starting at $50 one way, new destinations you want to see, and the flexibility you gotta have.
Sometimes you take it easy. And sometimes you can make it easy. That's the fine life, baby.
Turn today's dreams into tomorrow's trips with millions of flexible booking options all in one place. Expedia.
Time for the Menards game summary tonight for Fastener Forum. Memphis, 23 assists on 39, made field goals 59%. The Bucks, we wanted them to pass. They're passing 25 on 32 makes. That's 78%, which is outstanding. Grit Forum's 14 points, 2 of 7 on threes. And Dylan Brush, 19 points. Without the benefit of a three, he's 0 for 3 on triples, 8 of 13 for Memphis.
Yeah, now we'll see if Memphis can really maintain this for the next 10-plus minutes, because they played a heck of a game, but it feels like the Bucks have stuck around. They've done enough, right? Offense has been good. They've responded a lot. They've kept it close, but now it's the fourth quarter. Bucks have Giannis. Grizzlies have John Morant. Last time, came down to the last shot. Bucks had Jrue Holiday.
Jay Tucker stumbles and then gets down into the play and is called for the foul against Grayson Allen.
Yeah, one thing Tucker's going to do is he's going to bring the physicality, but he's willing to put his nose in there. I guess that's how it ends up sometimes. You're willing to scrap and try to knock it away, but that base close enough, sometimes you get popped. Part of me thinks PJ, he likes to get elbowed. It gets him going. It's looking like that one might not have been so good.
Well, then he picks up a foul on this end. The officials have been conferring. They'll probably look at this. There was a time in the NBA where this kind of an elbow, well, it wasn't a sweat, really. I was going to say, when you used to get the ball and move your elbow side to side or swing them, it was a foul.
Yeah.
He came up rather than moving the elbow.
Yeah, they certainly...
The previous foul on Tucker is under review to see if it meets the criteria for a flagrant foul.
They're not looking at the elbow. They're looking at the Tucker foul committed against Grayson Allen.
Yeah, that's interesting. I suppose when it's the play right away in transition following after PJ got hit in the face with the Grayson Allen elbow, if that's kind of what caused it, is that it's PJ in transition fouling Grayson, but
that's the elbow.
Yeah, no call. They let him play. And I think he came down and PJ fouled Grayson. Didn't look like anything out of the ordinary. Very, very Grayson Allen-esque, though. Hit somebody in the face with an elbow and put the camera on him. He's got a little bit of a smirk on his face. He was known at Duke for tripping guys at times. I'm not saying he had PJ on purpose. I'm just saying he had a reputation for some plays, suspended for some time for tripping, something you don't often see in basketball.
Now, when David Guthrie said they were going to replay, he said, take a look at the foul. He said, at the Tucker foul. Well, there was no foul call there. And so the reach-in foul.
After replay review, the foul on PJ Tucker is a common foul.
The reach-in foul breaks that decision.
Yeah, because they did.